Hey guys, in this video we're going to cover the built-in synthesizer that comes with Reaper. There's only one available in Reaper, but it's a bit limited on its own. It is possible to get a lot of different free and paid plugins to work with Reaper, but for this video we'll be sticking with the built-in instrument. Before starting this video, make sure you've checked out the rest of the series so you're all caught up. So the plugin we'll be using to generate synth sounds in Reaper is called ReaSynth. We'll add this plugin as a new virtual instrument track like we did in the previous video with our other plugins. To start manipulating the sound, we'll want to have our track armed for recording with a MIDI controller, that way we can easily hear the different sounds. I'm using my Akai MPD218 MIDI controller for this, and I'll link to those in the video description for you guys to check out. They're best for drums, but they will allow me to control MIDI without having to exit the plugin and listen to what it sounds like at different velocities. Whatever MIDI controller you have access to will work fine for this, but I find it necessary to have one to work efficiently with this plugin. The first thing we'll take a look at with this plugin is the wave shape. This is where we'll get most of the control for the plugin. The first option at the top is the square mix. This shifts the sound between a sine wave and a square wave. At 0, it's all sine wave, and at 1, it's all square wave. Below that is the pulse width, and that changes the tone of the square wave, but not the sine wave. Then below, we can adjust the level of the sawtooth mix and triangle mix. The extra sine mix is a bit of a special case. This blends the wave generator above with the separate sine wave. At 0, there's no extra sine wave. At 1, it's only the extra sine wave. On its own, the extra sine wave doesn't do anything unless you detune it. You can detune it just slightly to get an oscillating sound, or minus or plus 1200 to make it an octave down or up. This helps add depth to these waves we generated. Now let's get into some of the settings we have up above. First is the volume for the overall synth, and that's pretty self-explanatory. Next is the tuning, and we can detune the entire synth. We'll come back to this in a minute. After that, we have timing controls. First is the attack. The default is a very short attack, which means the synth comes on almost instantly. A fast attack can make it sound like a click when it starts. A slow attack is more of a fade-in. Decay and sustain sort of work together. Sustain is the level that we can have it drop down to after the initial attack. The default is 0, so there's no decrease in volume as we hold the note. We can have it decrease or even swell and increase if we want. The decay time is how long it takes to reach sustain while holding the note down. The release is how fast the note fades out when we release it. It can be nearly instantaneous or a longer fade. Even after adjusting the wave shape and dynamics of our synth plugin, there's only so much we can do with a single plugin to make interesting sounds. Here's what it sounds like so far. The real fun comes when we start automating changes with an LFO and layering different synths and plugins. The next thing I'm going to do with this synth is add a second layer. It will be almost identical to the first, but pitch shifted to give it a slight out of tune oscillated sound that adds more depth. To do this, I'll right click on the first plugin and copy it, then paste it down below. The only thing I'll change is the tuning to minus 15. Now when we play something, we can hear the layering starting to happen. Shaping our synth sounds in Reaper is definitely not limited to only using the ReaSynth plugin. We can use a lot more plugins like chorus and reverb to shape it. For this video, I'm using both a chorus and reverb plugin, but I've taken them from a different digital audio workstation. The main idea behind this is the same with Reaper plugins, but I just got the sound I was looking for with these instead. Simply add the chorus and reverb plugins after your synths in the effects chain to alter the sound. Let's hear what just adding the chorus does. So that creates a subtle change in our sound. It really starts to smooth out when we add a reverb as well. You can get a smoother sound by changing the balance of the waves you're using, but it's never quite the same as applying these plugins afterwards. Let's hear it with a reverb as well. So this is a much better sound, and it's more useful for actually creating songs than with the original sound we had from just the synths. It's also given us a small amount of stereo spread, whereas the wave generators we started with were purely mono. If we want our sound to vary a little more, we can add different plugins like EQ to further shape it. On a normal audio recording, I usually use the EQ before the reverb, but feel free to put it after to really change it up when you're working with synths like this. In this case, let's try using a notch filter to change the tone. Then we'll go to the top of the plugin and use the parameter button. We'll click Parameter Modulation MIDI Link. Just make sure you've clicked on your parameter first to select it before doing this. Then we'll turn on LFO. This gives us options for how this parameter will vary. In our case, we'll be varying the notch frequency. The first slider at the top sets our baseline for the parameter that it will vary around. It can vary from this point at the center, bottom, or top of the range depending on what you choose for the direction down below. The speed of the oscillation is pretty obvious, but the strength just changes the amount that it varies against its baseline. We can also change the shape of the wave if we want to. Thanks for checking out this video on using the ReaSynth Synthesizer in Reaper. If this video helped you out, don't forget to give it a like, subscribe to the channel, and press the bell icon to get notifications whenever a new video is released. You can also check the video description for products featured in this video and links to social media accounts to stay up to date on all our new content.